All right, week number 3 in the GT3 Fanatec Challenge Fixed Series, car number 4. I botched both my qualifying laps, so I'm starting P14 in a 1.4K strength of field. 65 degree track temperature. I've done one of these already today, and it was an utter disaster off of someone else's mistake. I was rolling a pretty good race that could have had me in the top 5 if it finished well. A guy spun out in front of me, did not hold his brakes, and basically took me out of the running. I lost a ton of iRating and a ton of safety rating in that race. So I'm looking for a little bit of redemption. But of course, this is a tough track, Red Bull Ring. If you've never driven it, it's quite fun. It's got a lot of flow to it. A lot of tricky technical parts to be fast here. So that's the part that we're hoping we can exercise and our way up the field here a little bit, because we're starting so far back. I noticed that starting with P12 on back, none of these people have qualified. So we're placed in line in terms of
good luck, everyone.
I rating.
The track temp is 65 Fahrenheit, 14th. Follow car number 1 in the right column.
Jim gets that right about 50% of the time.
Catch up to car number 1.
Car number 1 looked like a professional race car driver where he was swerving. I don't know what I meant by that, but there you go.
All right, Chip, be ready. Watch for the lights. Go, go, go.
Thank you.
Okay, Chip. Hold your nerve, just keep it smooth. No mistakes. Chip, nicely done. Position. Don't let him through.
Okay.
P9. Pushing him, there'll be a chance here.
Thank you.
Okay, Chip, you need to pass this twat. You're losing too much time.
It's the blue, my brother.
Behind is reeling you in. The gap is now 0.9. Pass, eyes front. Okay, Chip, don't let this guy distract you. To go, 2 minutes. Shit, Chip. Come on, mate, defend your position.
I think I can learn something from this guy. This is the guy who's been the fastest time in the race so far.
E9. flag one more lap.
Needed to give him room, compromise my exit. It looks like he freaked himself out, so... Unless I screw up again, I should be safe. What was I saying?
That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes. P9. There we go, it's over. Bring it back round.
11 fucking X. Sure, why not? Managed to squirrel out a top 10 finish, although it's not my proudest achievement, all things being considered. Definitely tired of getting hit from the rear by other drivers that are either overly ambitious or forget the fact that despite they may be fast, if cars are slower in front of you, you have to account for that. And it's like every race I've been in, probably the last four or five races, there's been at least one incident where I've been tagged from behind. Now, I've done it once, I think, in the last five races as well to someone else, but by and large, it's me getting hit and losing, you know, four incident points as a result. And it's just, it's tiring. Tonight I got seven incident points on my own in this race, with track limits, which I swear they have changed something with the track limits. Cause the last time I raced this track, I drove very, very similar lines and didn't have nearly as many off tracks, but that's another issue entirely. But just the getting hit from the back, getting hit from behind is just tiring. Enough about that. At least I was able to end tonight with a positive iRating. Not a lot, but you know, it's the last race of the year, so at least I got a little something out of it. This was split 5 out of 8 splits, with a 14-20 strength of field, so not stellar in terms of where it sits in the general scheme of things, but you know, you take what you can get. I started as car number 4 in this lot, in starting position 14, again, because I pooched qualification, basically paid the price there. Had I qualified better, I probably would have gotten a much better result, even potentially in the top 10, or not top 10, top 5, simply because I did have pace, to put down, a pretty decent time. Given the competitors and how they qualified. So if I'd gotten at least reasonably close, I could have qualified in the top 4 or 5, and that would have changed the complexion of the race. So again, qualifying is extremely important. Gotta remember that. Incident points, with the tap from behind and the 7 that I carried myself with off tracks, a total of 11, which dropped me 29 points further in my safety rating. Anything above 2 is fluff anyway, right? So I'll just have to put in some races where I am ultra, ultra careful and not racing quite so hard, although that always makes the iRating suffer a little bit. If you're too cautious, you wind up giving away things that you shouldn't. That's irritating. But all in all, positive iRating, a little bit of loss of safety rating, and a top 10 finish. Can't complain about that. I got to figure out why my smoke detector is going off now. So have a great night. Happy New Year. And may your 2022 be better than your 2021. Take care.
Nach Rennsport.